Using keyboard shortcuts are an essential part of navigating and using your Mac productively. Throughout my years of using my Mac, I've picked up a lot of useful shortcuts here and there. That being said, there are just so many and they can quickly get overwhelming, which is why I've compiled 20 of my favorite keyboard shortcuts into an easy digestible guide. I've also set up timestamps, so you can skip ahead or come back to the video later. We're going to start with shortcuts for the very tool you're watching this video on, your browser. Let's say you're watching this video, but you somehow closed the tab by mistake. If you press Command-Shift-T, you can restore your last closed tab. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, if you're feeling overwhelmed, that's fine because I've put these keyboard shortcuts in a document which I'll link right down below in the description. To open a new tab to search something up, you can press Command-T. If the text for the search result is too small, just press Command and plus to zoom in and minus to zoom out. If you ever need to screenshot anything, press Command-Shift-3 to capture the whole screen, Command-Shift-4 to capture a specific part, and Command-Shift-5 to start a recording. Since I won't be using my browser anymore, I'll press Command-Q to quit the app. Moving on to the desktop, there are some useful keyboard shortcuts to use here, like Command-Space to open Spotlight. This is arguably the most important shortcut because it allows you to open apps, find files, and so much more. I have replaced it with Raycast though, a better version, and yes, I've also made a video on that. If you've ever wanted to move the icons in your menu bar, just hold down Command and drag the icon with your trackpad. Command-Tab will open the app switcher, where you can switch through your opened apps, which brings us onto Pages. But why Pages of all places? The following shortcuts will apply to anywhere when you're dealing with text, so online articles, text processors, anywhere. Let's say you've written a long text and want to paste it somewhere. Instead of selecting everything with your cursor like this, you can press Command-A to select everything. Now to copy it, press Command-C and press Command-V to paste the text. You can also use Command-X if you want to cut the text, but still be able to paste it. Another way to select text is to press Shift and an arrow key to select individual characters. You can also just use the arrow keys to jump through text. Emojis are always fun, and you can press Command-Option-Space to open the Emojis menu. If you need to find a specific word in a text, you can do so by pressing Command-F and entering the letters, and it'll show you all the times that word appears in that text. Command-Z allows you to revert something if you made a mistake, for example, like this. Now that your work's done and you want to print your document off, press Command-P, and then save it by pressing Command-S or Command-Shift-S to save it as something else. Oh yeah, I promised a bonus at the end. If you've ever used an app and didn't know where the settings menu was, just press Command plus comma and it'll open the settings menu for you. If you like this compilation, you'll also like this 20 Mac tips and tricks video, so go watch it.